Yes, students, yesterday I told you about the chapter Shoemaker to you, and I gave brief introduction of this chapter from where this chapter has been taken. I hope you have remembered it. So today we are going to read this chapter. Okay, this read a story about an imprisoned shoemaker. Actually, this is the story of a imprisoned shoemaker. Okay, let's start the chapter. "Good day," said Monsieur Defarge, looking down at the white head that bent low over the shoemaking. Yesterday I told you about the characters of the chapter, and I told you, I hope you have remembered, Mr. and Mrs. Defarge. So here actually Monsieur is the title or post, as we use Mr. or Miss. So this is title, Mr. Defarge. Mr. Defarge went to meet Mr. or Dr. Manet, and he said good day to Dr. Manet. And Dr. Manet was busy in shoemaking, looking down at white head that bent low over the shoemaking, and he looked at the white head. White head means Mr. Manet was old now, and Mr. Defarge looked at him, and he was busy in shoemaking. It was raised for a moment, and a very faint voice responded to the greeting, as if it were at a distance. And for a moment, for some time, for a very few moment, he raised his hand or head, and in a very faint voice, in a very low or slow voice, he responded to Mr. Defarge, "Good day. You are still hard at work, I see." Mr. Defarge said, "You are still working very hard, and you are too busy in making shoe." After a long silence, the head was lifted for another moment, and the voice replied, "Yes, I'm working." After a long silence, after long time, he answered Mr. Defarge, and he replied that, "Yes, I am working." The faintness of the voice was pitiable and dreadful. It was not the faintness of physical weakness, though confinement and hard fare no doubt had their part in it. The faintness of voice means, what is the meaning of faintness? Faintness means a temporary loss of consciousness due to decreased flow of blood, or due to some circumstances, or due to some problem. Now, the faintness of Dr. Manet was easily seen, and it was pitiable and dreadful. Pitiable means contemplity, poor or pity. And dreadful means fearful, or causing or involving great suffering or fear. So the faintness of his voice was clear. It was not due to physical weakness. Means the faintness of voice, not the result of physical weakness of Dr. Manet, though confinement and hard fare no doubt had their part in it. It was the faintness of solitude and disuse. Confinement means it is given in the state of being forced to stay in a closed space or prison. Whenever a person has to forced to live in a solitude. As I told you yesterday, that for 18 years, Dr. Manet imprisoned for 18 years, and there he used to live a solitude or life, and it was the result of solitude and disuse. Solitude means to live. Solitude means to live, or the state or situation of being alone. And disuse means the state of not being used. Because Dr. Manit was not in the condition to live or to meet with the people, because he lived for 18 years in the prison. "I want," said Defarge. "Yes, I want," said Defarge, who had not removed his gaze from the shoemaker, "to let in a little more light here. You can bear a little more." Now Defarge said that, and he gazed, means looking seriously to stare something, and he asked shoemaker that why you didn't open the door and why you didn't allow little light to come in the room, and you can bear a little more. And he said that you can tolerate the light. The half open door was opened a little further. A broad ray of light fell into the garret. Garret means a place on the roof and that is used like a storeroom. So the half door opened. The door of the room was half opened, and Mr. Defarge opened a little bit, and then a broad ray of light fell into the garret, means in the storeroom, and showed the workman with an unfurnished shoe upon his lap. And now the shoemaker, means Dr. Manit, was making the shoe, and he was busy in making shoe. And when he opened the door and the light came into the room, what he saw? An unfurnished shoe. Unfurnished means incomplete. Shoe was kept in the lap of shoemaker, pausing in his labor. Now he stopped working. His few common tools and various scraps of leather were at his feet. Common tools. Tools means the material that is used and equipments that is used to make shoes. And various scraps. Scraps means bits or pieces. Pieces of leather were in the feet of Dr. Manit on his bench. He had a white beard. Because he was old, so his beard was white in color, redly cut. Means torn out, not in a proper shape, but not very long. It is not very long. It is here we are talking about the beard of the shoemaker. A hollow face. Hollow means empty, because there was no impression on the face of Dr. Manit. And exceedingly bright eyes. Exceedingly means to a great extent or extremely. Extremely bright eyed. His yellow rags of shirt lay open at the throat. Yellow rags of shirt means the shirt that he was wearing was not in a good condition. It was torn near about the throat. Okay. And showed his body to be withered and worn. Withered means wrinkled. Because he was old, so as you can see, your grandparents also, when we are old, on that time our skin is like wrinkled. And his body was wrinkled. He and his old canvas frock, loose stockings. He and his old canvas frock. Canvas frock means clothing of coarse material. Loose stocking. Stocking means long socks used to wear by men. And all his poor tatters of clothes, means torn out, that is not poor, or you can tatters say big clothes, had in a long seclusion from direct light and air, faded down to such a dull uniformity of parchment yellow. And in a long seclusion from direct light and air, faded down to such a dull uniformity. Because Dr. Manet was not habitual to live in light. He was living in a dark place. He was in prison for 18 years. That's why he was not habitual of the light. And one can easily see the uniformity or dull uniformity here in this room of parchment yellow, that it would have been hard to say which was which. Parchment yellow means material that is used in past time for writing, that is made from a skin of a skin of any animal. And it was very difficult to say that, it was very difficult to tell us about that which was which. Means parchment yellow, like a material that is used to write in past time, and Dr. Manet, because he was also old and he was looking like a parchment yellow paper. The shoemaker never looked at the figure before him. At the figure for a person, here figure used for Defarge. Shoemaker didn't give any attention to Mr. Defarge. Without first looking down on the side of himself, then on that, as if he had lost the habit of associating place with sound. And he didn't give any attention to Mr. Defarge. And after that, he just busy in his making shoe. And why it is so? Because he lost the habit of associating place. I told you yesterday also, because he was imprisoned for 18 years. And due to this long period of time, he was not in the position to meet people. So here, it is written here, he lost the habit of associating place with sound. And he was not habitual of the sounds also, because he lived in a solitude for 18 years. He never seen people, he never spoke there, he never heard any sound there, he never enjoyed the light, sunlight. So that's why he lost the habit of associating with place or sound or speaking. Without first wandering in the manner and forgetting to speak. And due to this 18 year long time in prison, he just forget and he lost the habit of associating with the place and sound, and he also forget to speak also. Here some difficult words have given, and today we read this first page of your chapter. In next video, we will discuss with other pages. Okay, students, till then, revise it and try to find out difficult words. And if you find any problem is there, then you can ask me. Okay, students, bye-bye.